The troubles are more I've been living. And this ain't wings and I'm Thank you.
Living in left, coke, cover, cafe, cover.
Thanks, Newcastle. This is really cool. We're really happy to be playing here again, and last night was cool. And tonight's going to be cool, too. Tonight's going to be especially cool because we've got special surprises. I don't know if anyone else has any surprises, but I've got some pretty cool things to tell you guys. You ready?
Across the night was the moon that stole my slumber. Across the night, I fell in love with people sleeping. Sleeping this feeling. Of course the night was the moon that stole my slumber. Of course the night I fell in love with people sleeping. Across the night, across the night, across the night, I heard your man's up in its shoulder. Without a leash on the line around me. Don't mean to make you cry, but this feeling's the one breath through the night. And I'll only make you cry, but this feeling. Across the night, my slumber across the night. I fell in love with people sleeping across the night, across the night, across the night.
Just wanna be alone.
long as you're here.
Gotta hurt, ain't gonna love the flame, but painting down for hate.
love you better.
Thank you. This song was made for dancing, and these shoes were made for walking, and this mouth is made for talking, and those hands are made for clapping.
such a great tour. We've been having so much fun and everyone's in really good spirits, like every single person, and oh, what else could you ask for?
So we wanted to play a show in two sets basically because we wanted to, I guess, encapsulate both sides of what Silverchair were and what Silverchair become.
It's gonna be real good.
Yeah.
That's what I heard. Intermission, old stuff, intermission, new stuff.
Well, the choice of doing theatres, I just seemed the right thing to do is do a more of a theatre kind of show with the two sets, and just works really well. And where tonight's show is coming from, the Civic in Newcastle.
The set list really is quite eclectic, and we're playing a lot of the songs that we've never played before in a live environment. We've really, you know, we really recorded them and then, you know, tried to play them. And it's worked really well. It's been really fun, and so there are definitely surprises. Because we're on stage for almost 2 hours, longer than 2 hours most nights, we thought it would be good visually to change things around, and the second bracket's very traditional, and we changed the whole back line, and it's basically just park hands, and we just wanted to make it really traditional, kind of rock, like really inspiring.
What do you think of the show so far?
Excellent. It's awesome.
It's brilliant.
Unbelievable. It's a god.
Is there a particular song you've been looking forward to seeing?
Maybe Without You, yeah. Waiting for that song, but amazing band.
It's been going great. It's been a little weird the first few shows, just walking out and seeing people all season, which was a bit imposing at first, but by the time the second set rolls around, they're generally up and getting into it and rocking.
For the Across the Night tour, the band made us aware that they wanted the show in two parts, like theatre style. Our brief was given that they wanted Act 1 and Act 2 to be completely different visually, and that's where our starting point came. So I spoke with the band about their stage instruments. Naturally, it had to work from a musical sense so they could perform, and we figured out that we would use the backline as a stage prop and change that around between Act 1 and 2. So once that was decided, we handed over those plans to Hugh, who had to put a light show on top of it.
With respect to the lights, the band wanted to... the first half of the show, Act 1, was to concentrate mainly on the orchestral and more musical and colourful songs, whereas the second act would be more the rock show. So the lights had to also reflect that. We had video screens placed behind the band, which had picture frames, set pieces around them, rings that attached to the band's backline. A lot of the lights were hidden from view, which is different to what we usually do for our show, and that was to give a more theatrical kind of approach. Part of the planning for this tour, we realised that with all the gear moving around and the completely different looks that we needed to be able to see every view of the stage before anything was set up to present it to the band, and so we ourselves could work out if it would be technically possible. So a 3D drawing was built. The whole stage was plotted into a 3D space. It was much more effective to be able to see it and see the stage from any angle, from the point of view of the crowd or from the point of view of the musicians. So all the instruments and lighting and the stage itself was built to scale in this 3D space, and we were able to move around and look at the stage. we were able to show everybody exactly how it would look, and if anyone had any concerns or suggestions, they could see it in the drawing and the stage as it would look in a 3D space without waiting until the first show and seeing it all set up.